We're coming up on Mountain Frost Pear ahead of us. Look at that, man, that's some nice fall color. We're ranging between the orange, purple, still got some green in there as well. Off to the left, we do have cardinal dogwood here. That's another great large shrub. But that Mountain Frost Pear, when I first planted it, I thought it was gonna be sterile, no fruit. That is absolutely not the case. I'm getting quite a bit of fruit that is developing on this. So if you have other pears in the area, you're gonna have to be careful. You're gonna get some cross-pollination. So this is about a 30-foot tree as it gets to its mature size. So I would put it in the medium category. But man, look at the spring white flowering on this tree. Just another great characteristic of the plant for sure. It's got a nice glossy green leaf in the summer as well. These pears, they do not seem to be edible at any stage. They have a sour, bitter taste. If you're looking for edible pears, Ure and Golden Spice would be two hardy varieties that I recommend. That's what I'm growing. I do actually pick up my pears because the deer can come in the winter and it just draws them in and they can cause damage. The Mountain Frost Pear is also hardy to zone 3, so it'll really tolerate the cold winters up in the northern plains in the upper Midwest. We're in the first week of October and this is a Northern Empress Japanese Elm. We're starting to see some of that burgundy. This is an elm that stays smaller than most elms. It doesn't have much of a seed crop either. Typically elms have a yellow fall color, but this one's got that burgundy. So this is something that is new in the nursery stock pipeline. Our elm was planted about 14 months ago. We came across a nice B&B specimen. B&B stands for bald and burlap. You're looking at the root ball and it's wrapped in burlap. Another North Dakota State University introduction. We're hoping for good things out of this tree. Unfortunately, we had a hard frost about a week ago, or a killing frost. So this elm, we're not gonna see the bright burgundies that we had hoped for. We got to see a little bit of it. We've got some leaves that are pretty crispy now, just a matter of some hard winds, and they're gonna be falling off the tree. Hard frosts or killing frosts, they don't affect all trees the same way. Some are still gonna finish out and give us a good show. But what is a hard frost? What's a killing frost? It's something where you get the temperatures are sustained cold for not just a short period of time, but almost all evening. And we drop down to 17 to 19 degrees Fahrenheit for a long period that evening. Now that's going to completely put most plants into total dormancy. And that's okay. If you're growing hardy plants for the northern region, they're ready for that. They'll just automatically go into dormancy. Nothing to worry about there. We covered the buckeyes in a recent video on some fall colors. Brilliant red fall color, but not for this one. Look at this. Yeah, the leaves are just gone. It's fully set up for dormancy. If you take a look at that bud there, healthy, everything looks good. This is gonna go into winter just fine, even with that hard killing frost. A couple weeks ago, we did some fall color videos and we looked at the showy mountain ash. The berries were what we highlighted, but man, look at that fall color now. So you get the berries and the fall color. What a great tree. Take a look at that video if you want to see some different fall colors. Even though some plants get hammered with that killing frost, look at this viburnum. It's a red balloon wayfaring viburnum, no problem. Picking up some nice burgundy here. That's kind of rare for the wayfaring viburnums. Oftentimes they'll just freeze off green, so I'm a little bit surprised. So here we go, killing frost, but this one's gonna finish out and give us a nice show. And another really nice birch tree that wasn't affected by those cold temperatures, 17 degrees Fahrenheit. Look at that, Parkland Pillar Birch. That's gonna finish out and give us some beautiful yellow fall color. This is a first editions release from Bailey Nurseries, one of my favorite birches. It didn't get the dieback we got a couple years ago where it took out birch all across our state. These Dakota pinnacles, I had to take them out. I had three of them, they were beautiful, but it killed them back about halfway. And I gotta mention too, look at that red Splendor flowering crab in the background. That might get some fall color as well. But look at those berries. The birds are gonna clean those up this winter. Awful fun to watch them. As you can see, that cold weather took care of pretty much all the fall color we had going on the Mountain Frost Pear. But we've still got some of those persistent fruits that we can enjoy. Thanks for watching Garden Hike. We'll see you again next time.